Tuesday evening. I'm Dylan Radigan. Singular, getting connected, the nation's number two cellular service provider, paying $41 billion to acquire rival AT&T Wireless. The deal would create the nation's biggest cell phone company. So what does the deal mean for customers and competitors alike? Jeff Kagan, independent telecom industry analyst. Tony Figueredo, analyst at Criterion Research, and Becky Quick of the Wall Street Journal. And Jeff, as the industry analyst here, answer me this. Is, in fact, Verizon the biggest winner in this, and that their arch rival paid a fortune for it, and they've eliminated one of their competitors?
Oh, I guess you could look at that as the silver lining in the cloud. But, you know, frankly, this is something that Singular and AT&T both needed. This is a deal that completes both companies because it'll fill in all of their weak spots and enable them to provide better quality service, something that Verizon has really enjoyed in the last few years.
But Tony, is the price too high?
No, I think it was a fair price for what Singular is getting, and situations like this do not come around very often, so I think that they paid an appropriate price.
Now, having said that, though, what you can see is Vodafone shares kind of trading up on this news, though. There was a lot of relief over the last couple of days when it started looking like they weren't going to be the ones to walk away with it. What do you see happening there? This is such a great deal, and the loser stock trades up on that. What's that tell you?
Well, I think it says that that the deal was much more important for Singular than it would have been for Vodafone, because for Vodafone, it would have just been extending in the U.S. with their own brand, whereas for Singular, they can take a lot of costs out of the system as they already have massive operations in the U.S. with the same technology that AT&T Wireless has.
Jeff, on that point, does that then make me a buyer of either SBC or Bell South as a way to play this deal?
Well, you know, I'm not a financial analyst. I don't recommend the stocks, but I would just like to talk about the premium that you were talking about a moment ago.
Sure.
You have to realize that there's only going to be two, maybe three mergers that are going to be allowed by the regulators. We're going to go from six down to four providers. If one of them happens to be Vodafone and doesn't take a player off the playing field, then they're going to allow three. But that's it. Every player wants to participate in this merger wave. That means that there's a limited supply, and you're going to have premiums paid by these companies. So I think part of what we're going to be expecting is to make sure that the value in the future is more than just voice that we think of when we think of wireless phone service. The future of wireless phone service is more than just today's value. The future of wireless phone service has to do with all the high-speed wireless data, all the broadband offerings that will come in over the wireless connection, including these wireless companies. Nobody's talking about this, but Singular will be able to provide wireless phone service to the home by putting a repeater on the side of the house and be able to compete outside of Bell South and SBC's territory by providing a high-speed connection to the home wirelessly. You don't need a wire anymore. Sprint announced something similar in their analyst meeting 2 weeks ago when they talked about the household hub. We're talking about all sorts of new innovative technologies that don't exist today, but these are where the big growth opportunities are.
Tony, who does this put the most pressure on to make the next move?
I think the two companies that would be under the most pressure would be T-Mobile and Nextel, as being the two smallest out of the big six players, in order to make sure that they survive the big fight.
You know, one other question, Jeff. A lot of analysts are saying today this doesn't really change the outlook. There's still going to be a lot of competition, even though it takes out a player. Would you agree with that? Has this changed the dynamics of the industry at this point?
It's not going to change the pricing dynamics of the industry. What this is really about is about making Singular a stronger company because it's going to be taking a lot of costs out of the system. You don't need two stores, AT&T Wireless store and a Singular store in every block. But it also means a much improved customer experience for their customers. Let's face it, AT&T Wireless and Singular are both very big, but they've had some problems in this past year, and the problems are related to the way all wireless companies are wrestling with is a limited spectrum and limited capacity. This is basically going to double their capacity and double their spectrum in all areas, giving the customer a much better experience. It's not going to happen this year. It's going to take them a whole year to close the deal. It's not going to happen the first month of next year because it's going to take them several quarters to be able to integrate them. But once these are integrated, if you take a look at the footprints and the maps, you see a very, very deep and wide footprint that's covered by this new company, and the customers will be benefited by a lot better service. It's not about price, and it's about better service.
And we'll leave it on that note. Jeff Kagan, Tony Figueredo, thank you very much, Becky, of course. I will see sooner than later. Intel saying it will introduce a 64-bit